what's your attitude toward dead people? I asked Sekerdon Mikhailovich. Absolutely negative, said Sekerdon Mikhailovich. I'm afraid of them. Yeah, I can't stand dead people either, I said. Were I to bump into a dead person, and if he wasn't a relative, I'd probably kick him. One shouldn't kick dead people, said Sekerdon Mikhailovich. I would give him a boot right in the muzzle, I said. I just can't stand dead people and children. Yeah, children are disgusting, Sekerdon Mikhailovich agreed. In your opinion, what's worse, dead people or children, I asked. Children, I'd say, are worse. They get in the way more often. You have to admit that people don't burge into our lives like that, said Sekerdon Mikhailovich. They do burge in, I yield and quickly shut up. Sekerdon Mikhailovich scrutinized me closely. Some more vodka? He asked. No, I said, but getting a hold of myself added. No, thank you, I don't want any more. I walk over and sit down at the table again. For some time, we stay silent. I want to ask you a question, I say finally. Do you believe in God? A perpendicular wrinkle appears on Sekerdon Mikhailovich's forehead, and he says, there exist impolite actions. It is impolite to ask a man to loan you 50 rubles if you saw that he just put 200 in his pocket. It's his business whether to give you the money or to decline. And the most convenient and pleasant way to decline is to lie that you have none. You have seen that this man has the money, and thereby you have stripped him of the opportunity to simply and pleasantly decline. You have stripped him of his right to choose, and that's rotten. It is an impolite and tactless act, and to ask a person, do you believe in God? It's also an impolite and tactless act. Well, I said, there is no comparison, and I am not comparing, said Sekerdon Mikhailovich. Well, all right, I said, let's drop it. Only forgive me for asking you such an impolite and tactless question. Please, said Sekerdon Mikhailovich, after all, I simply declined to answer you. I too would not have answered, I said, but for a different reason. And what would that be, asked Sekerdon Mikhailovich, indifferently. You see, I said, in my opinion, there are no believers or non-believers. There are only those who want to believe and those who do not want to believe. So, those who do not want to believe already believe in something, said Sekerdon Mikhailovich, and those who want to believe already believe in nothing. That's maybe, I said, I don't know. And what is it that they believe or do not believe in God? Asked Sekerdon Mikhailovich. No, I said, in immorality, in immortality. Then why did you ask me whether I believed in God? Simply because to ask, do you believe in immortality, sounds stupid somehow, I said to Sekerdon Mikhailovich and stood up. Are you leaving? Sekerdon Mikhailovich asked me. Yes, I said, it's time. But what about the vodka? Asked Sekerdon Mikhailovich. There is just enough left for but a glass each. Well, let's finish it, I said. We drank the vodka and chased it with what was left of the boiled meat. And now I must go, I said. Goodbye, said Sekerdon Mikhailovich, walking me from the kitchen to the stairs. Thank you for the refreshments. I thank you, I said, goodbye. And I went. Left alone, Sekerdon Mikhailovich cleared the table, threw the empty vodka bottle on top of the cupboard, put his fur hat with the ear flaps back on his head, and sat down on the floor by the window. Sekerdon Mikhailovich laid his hands behind his back, where they were not to be seen, and from underneath his hiked up robe protruded bare bony legs, shod in Russian boots, with their tops cut off.